What's going on, babes? It's your girl Jalen J, and welcome back to my channel. Happy freaking new year. I really wanted to yell that, so turn the volume down because I want to like yell happy new year. So let's do that intro again. Family, I know they be like, this girl is so stupid, she's so annoying. But y'all, it's the new year, it's freaking 2020, and I'm actually pretty excited to see what I have in store for myself this year and all the other freaking years. Like, I'm just super excited. Like, seriously, honestly, I'm genuinely like just super excited. So as you can see by the title, I will be sharing with you all some things that I'm doing this year that I've started doing like last year and I wanted to continue to do this year. So just some, like, you know, what you want to call it, good habits and just daily routines that I do to get myself up and motivated and going, because if you ain't gonna support or motivate yourself or be determined, then who is gonna be like that for you? You know what I'm saying? So, yeah, without further ado, let's just go ahead and get into this video. Yeah. Okay. So, the first thing I wanted to start off with are planners. Now, I've had a planner since I can remember, like, I think I've had, like, a planner since I was little, but, like, when I was in school, but hold on. Pause. Why am I out of breath? Okay. So anyway, I've had a planner since I could remember. Thanks to my mom for doing this, because like at the time when I was younger, I was only using planners for like, oh, to write down homework or whatever the case may be. So now that I'm older, I'm using a planner / a to-do list to just clear my head, make sure I have everything that I want completed is completed. So the first thing I got is this planner, and it is called the Hustler's Agenda. Now, I think this company is based out of Canada, and y'all, this, not only is it cute and sleek and just simple and black, because y'all know my favorite color is like black, but this really is a really good planner. Like, everything about it is really good. I just received it, even though I ordered it on Christmas, and I just got it like 2 days ago, so I think they just probably like had back order. But if you don't have a planner and you need one, go ahead and buy you one, like, seriously. So within the planner, they have they just have some motivational things in there. They have the 3-year glance, where it has the next 3 years already in here. Sorry, my phone. They have a year summary. So they have something that's called, they have a title, main goal and side goal, and then they break up the month in, you know, the quarter. So I guess within that, if you can see it, I guess with that, you can go ahead and just like write down whatever goals you want to accomplish, whether they're long-term or short-term goals, in this box. And yeah, so another cool thing that this planner has is a budget forecast and monthly budget part. Now, I've never used anything like this. I don't know how to use anything like this, but I'll YouTube it and try to figure it out. And write down this, because this is like super cute and just easy. And this year I'm really trying to get work on my finances, because it's like a struggle. So that's one thing that I like about this planner. They have quotes, like monthly quotes by different people. This one is unknown, but I think I saw a quote by Nipsey Hussle in here. They got a quote by Issa Rae, of course. They just have quotes, and it's Now, when it comes to the month part, like, you have to fill that out yourself. I already went ahead and filled out, like, my work schedule for the month of January in here, as well as, like, things that, you know, have been planned from last year that I completely forgot about. I went ahead and put that in there. And then what else is, like, nice about this planner, they have weekly reminders. So I just, on the side right here, I think y'all can see that, remember throughout the week, because sometimes I can be really forgetful. So that's just like a little checklist of mine that I put on this side. But other than that, I think this planner is super cute. I like it. It's all black. Like how I like things nice and sleek, like nice and simple. So yeah, I'll be sure to like add their Instagram and like their website in the description box, so you all can go ahead and just go ahead and purchase this, because this planner is real cute and it will help you stay organized. So period poo, get the planner. And that's it. So, on the business side of things, I just received the Mink, the Hustle Planner, and my mom ordered this for Christmas. Hey, mommy, thank you. I'm using this for my business, Najee. If you don't know, I have my own Mink lash line called Najee, where I'm giving you girls, you know, nice, simple, but luxury lashes. So if you want to go ahead and purchase, go ahead and make a purchase, follow your girl, support your girl, and that's it, period. So this, I think, will really help me throughout the year. She also had, so my mom got me a bundle deal, so it also came with a book. So the book is super cute. She looks so beautiful on here. But I noticed within the book they have she has different like key terms, you know, definitions of key terms and stuff like that. It's very active, so it has like 10 questions every brand should ask itself, and you get to fill out everything that, you know, all the questions she has listed right here. You fill it out, and I guess it's just like a reflecting type of book, and I guess she gives her points, how to document, okay, brand recognition, stay modern. Like, this is super cool. So I'll be definitely using both of these things to help me and Najee and my other brands. So if y'all want a bundle deal, you know what I'm saying, you want to purchase it, go ahead and purchase it, and we can do it together. So yeah, this year that I'm really taking serious this year, seriously, in all seriousness, are freaking books. So one of my goals this year is to complete one book every month. Literally one book every month. You know, vocabulary is important, spelling is important, and reading is just kind of fun. It's like really relaxing. When I read, I'm now listening to jazz music or like classical music or something. Girl, when the hell did I start doing that? Because I don't do stuff like that. So I guess as you get older, you start to, you know, try and do different things. So the book that I'm reading for the month of January right now is called Make Your Bed and Y'all. It has 9 chapters, and I'm already on chapter 6, and I just got this book Sunday at Target. I really love this book. Like, honestly, I've already highlighted, I'm a highlighter person, but I already highlighted like half of the chapters already, because it just has like important points in this book that I know will stick with me. So if you want to know what the next book I'm planning on reading come February, just follow me on Instagram. I have a whole highlight that I'll be just using that highlight to dedicate to books. So all that to say, you don't have to read the book that I'm reading, but if you want to, go ahead and get it. So the next thing that I do, that I did last year, that I will be bringing into this year, is the blessing jar. So I got this idea off of, I believe, Pinterest, and I use this jar pretty much to fill up all the blessings that I feel like, all the blessings or all the good things that happen to me throughout the year, and at the end of the year, I'll pour them out and read them just to remind myself. Because y'all, last year, it was good, okay? It was real good. I really thank God, I appreciate God for putting me in, you know, situations or just simply meeting certain people and having an encounter with certain people that I would have never thought that I would have met or I would have been doing or whatever the case may be. So these are my blessings from last year that I have not yet emptied out and reread, but yeah, so this is just my blessing jar. So this will, I had a few blessings that just happened within the last 6 days of this year, so that's real good. So I'm gonna dump these out, reread them, probably trash them, and probably keep the like ones that were like really important to me but somewhere else, and refill it and just fill this up and do it again come next year. So yeah, I use sticky notes. You can use a piece of paper, whichever, however, you can decorate yours however you want. But if you want to just remember all the good that has come to you, all the good that God has blessed you with, and you just want to remember it and relive the moment again, I definitely think you should go ahead and give this a try and comment below and let me know what type of things y'all are doing to remember God's blessings or with whatever you're manifesting. The last thing, your girl loves planners and journals, especially journals. Like I have, let's see, I think I have like 6 empty journals that have not been touched or used. I just like, I'm a hoarder for journals, so that's pretty much what it is. Journal for church. I use it mainly for church because it has a cute little scripture on there. It says, "Be still and know I am God." Psalms 46 verse 10. Period. He is God, the highest of all highs. Hallelujah. Let me stop there. I'm done. But yeah, I'm using this journal strictly for any sermons that I watch or any plans that I do within the Bible app that's on my phone. Or when I attend, you know, my church on Sundays, I just write, take notes right in here. I use this strictly for that. I always get these cute journals from either TJ Maxx, Marshalls, Ross, or Home Goods. So yeah, if you don't have a little notebook that you want to use, that you use for church, and you want to get one, go ahead and go to those stores. They, or order them, or whatever the case may be. But they really, those stores really have like the best journals for, that has scriptures on there for church. For me, that's just what I think. Other things that I'm doing this year to really get myself together, because I'll be 25 this year, so I need to stop. It's not that I'm immature, but it's time to like take it to the next level in maturity. So I'm just really trying to, not trying to, I'm putting myself in the position to just be mature, be consistent, and stay motivated, because it can sometimes get really hard for me. So those are just some little things that I'm doing. Oh, I do vision boards as well. I did a vision board specifically for my business, and I just got invited to attend a vision board party, I think next weekend, and that one I think will be very personal. So yeah, if you don't write but you want to cut and paste, vision boards are where it's at. You can get cardboard from anywhere, or you know, do a vision board on your phone. I know that they have a bunch of apps for that, I just don't know. But yeah, you can create a vision board. So I think that wraps up my video. Really, in all seriousness, guys, just take this year and kick ass with it, conquer everything. Like, do everything that you wanted to do last year or the years before. Do that now and just, you know, go ahead and feel like a bad bee. Conquer everything, sus. Conquer everything. Seriously, put God first. Put yourself first. Say no. Take your self-care very seriously. Support those that support you. Stay positive. Stay motivated. Don't procrastinate. Just stay consistent. All aspects, stay consistent with everything that you do. And yeah, this year is going to be amazing for you. This year is going to be amazing for me. And happy freaking new year, because it's a officially 2020 2020 2020 2020 2020 2020 2020 2020. Okay, I'm done. I'm sorry, y'all. But yeah, be sure to like, comment, and subscribe. You know, share with your good friends and your good girlfriends and they nieces and they aunts and they cousins and they uncles and all that jizzy jazz. I love you all so much. Thank you for tuning in, and I'll catch you in my next freaking video. It's freaking New Year's, y'all. God dang on New Year's 20 freaking. Happy New Year's. Bye, guys. Love you.